Hey everyone, this is Daryl, aka The Dig In, and tonight we had UFC Fight Night on Fox. It was Dos Anjos versus Cowboy Cerrone 2. It was the main card was, let's see, one, two, three, four fights. To be honest with you, I missed the prelims because I was out doing stuff, but the four fights are pretty good. One of them might have, you know, two of them you could have said might have been early stoppage. I think one of them may have been. But good stuff all the way around. We start out in the women's strawweight division. I always got my notes. That's why I'm looking down. We had Randa Marcos versus, I'm going to try this name once, Carolina Kowalkiewicz. And I know, ma'am, I am mispronouncing your name, and I thoroughly apologize. I'm so sorry. But Carolina, because I'm going to pronounce her by her first name, she got the win. It was a good fight, really, but they kind of, the first two rounds kind of went back and forth. Marcos, I think she really won the first round. Second round, I think, was kind of in between. In the third round, Carolina, she come through with a dominating performance in the third round. She has really good footwork, but her hands need to come up. Like, most of the time, her hands were around her waist. Get your hands up. You're going to get knocked out if you don't. But her footwork really saved her. Randa Marcos, she could not get her lined up. But Carolina, please, work on those hands. Get those hands up. I could see that this young lady, she's tough. She took some good punches. She delivered some good punches. But get those hands up. But I thought that was a really good fight overall, though. But Carolina, it was a unanimous decision. It's a good fight, real good fight. Next, Nate Diaz versus Michael Johnson. Diaz won by unanimous decision, 29-28 on all three cards. Totally agree. I think Johnson won the first round and the last two. Diaz dominated him. Now, I'm the first to say I'm not a fan of the Diaz brothers, but I will always give these guys their due. They're tough guys. The brothers are so tough. They're very cocky, very arrogant. This is on national TV. This is on Fox. At the end of the fight, Diaz goes on a profanity-ridden, just, I don't know what he was saying because it's all muted out. And I'm sorry, I'm a big fan. Just show some class when you win. Show some class if you lose. I mean, you're on national TV, and I don't even have no idea what he said because the whole thing was muted out. This guy, him and his brother, to me, I think they would be really good if they didn't have such a chip on their shoulder. But, you know, that's who they are. I'll be honest, I had to mute it because, what's his face? The announcers, they are so much on the Diaz brothers. They love them. Absolutely love them. I mean, I don't care what they do. They'll jump up and down like it's the greatest thing ever. Johnson had some good shots, hit him really solid a few times. You rarely hear the Joe Rogan. That's his name. I don't know why I couldn't think of him. Joe Rogan, he loves the Diaz brothers. Absolutely loves them. I don't care what they do. Rogan's going to jump up and down and say it was the greatest thing ever. And I'm the kind of guy that if you're doing great, I'll say it. If you're not doing great, I'll also say it. His hands are so fast. I mean, he was just teeing off, just shot after shot. His jab was so strong. And it's one thing I always tell the students that I help with, really work on that jab. It can set up everything. If you really get that solid jab down, just keep working on it. It's such a great punch. And people just kind of throw it away because it's not that powerful knockout, the powerful knockout punch. Keep working on it. And the Diaz brothers, they are so fast with them. They work so hard with them. But if they didn't have that chip on their shoulders, heck, I might even like them. Then again, maybe not. But those guys, really good. And Nate tonight, the second and the third round, he just thoroughly dominated. I mean, he took some hard punches. He delivered some hard punches. Great fight. Both guys, really tough. Neither one of them got knocked out. I think if they had gone another round, I think Johnson would have gotten knocked out. Diaz, he's really setting himself up for a title run. And which, to be honest with you, he should get one. He's that good. Again, I don't like him, but the man is good. He is good. Him and his brother are both really good. When their heads on straight and And Diaz, when their head's on straight, they can be at the top of the division, even champions in their divisions. But great fight, great fight. Diaz, good job, good win. The next one, the heavyweight division, Junior Dos Santos versus Alistair Overeem. Good fight here. It was a second round TKO for Overeem. This is the one I said may have ended a bit early. After I saw the replay again, I'm thinking, maybe not. He clocked Dos Santos pretty good. Overeem has a lot of power. I mean, you get the heavyweights, most of the time you're gonna have some guys throwing some heavy leather. And when I first saw it, like I said, I thought it was an early stoppage. I thought Dos Santos, he was still moving. It looked like he was trying to get up, but he was hit pretty good. I think I would have let it go a little bit longer, but yeah, it might not have lasted a lot longer after that. But second round TK, I think maybe a little bit early. But Alistair, he's a really good fighter. He's got good punches, a lot of power, a lot of power. I mean, him and Dos Santos, both of these guys, ton of power. But I think it's hard for me to get over those ones. I kind of think maybe it's a little bit early on the stoppage. In the last fight, championship fight, the headliner for the lightweight title, Rafael. I said it right because I usually think Rafael, but no, it's Rafael Dos Anjos. I hope I pronounced the Dos Anjos right. Rafael Dos Anjos versus Donald Cowboy Cerrone. This is their second match. Dos Anjos won the first one, and to me, it was a really good fight. For what little time it lasted, it was a first round TKO by Dos Anjos, retained his title. Good fight. He's really fast. He's really fast. And to be honest, coming in, I actually thought Cerrone was going to be the one coming out with the win. Not putting down Dos Anjos, but I just thought Cerrone was kind of on a roll, and I thought he was going to have that shot, and he was going to finally come through and get the title. Good fight for, like I say, only 1 minute 6 seconds. But he caught him with a really good knee, like just under the ribs, maybe liver area. Really good solid knee. And you can tell that took something out of him, out of Cerrone. And then he caught him with a really good kick. Again, right across the bread basket down there. Probably took his wind out. And then he finished him with some really good punches. It was one of those things that it could have actually been stopped 15 seconds earlier. And I don't think anyone would have said anything. And but you know, he got down in the middle of the cage and finished it. Good fight. The whole card, I mean the four fights I saw, because like I said, I did not see the prelims. Got them recorded, and I'll watch that in a little bit. But good stuff all the way around. The next UFC will be on January 2nd. Going to be a good fight. Good fight. You got Robbie Lawler against Robbie Lawler, the champion, against Carlos Condit. Those two guys, I just think they're going to put on a show. I'm a huge fan of Condit. So I remember him when he was in WC, I believe it was, and he always come in the natural born killer. And at first I was like, this is kind of a cocky, arrogant guy. He seems like a pretty decent guy. He might be a little cocky, arrogant, but he seems like a good guy. And he's a tough dude, really tough dude. And Lawler can take a hard punch, and he will deliver a hard punch. He's one of those guys I think will take a punch in order to hit you with one. And I think that's going to be a really good matchup. And the I don't say co-main event, but the other fight's going to be was it Steep Stipe Stipe Miocic versus the Pit Bull Andrei Arlovski. Should be a good fight. And it's kind of funny for me that I'm almost surprised that Arlovski, he's coming back. Well, actually not coming back. He's been on a comeback trail for a while. Because I remember when I was, a few years back, probably 5, 6, 7 years ago, he was up there heavyweight champ. And then he lost it. Seems like he just lost his skill. I mean, like his chin got real weak. But he seems like he's come back. And the Pit Bull, I've always liked him. He always come with the fangs on his mouthpiece. Always liked him. And I just think this could be a really good matchup as well. A few other good fights on the card, but that's going to be a good one on January 2nd pay-per-view. Can't wait for that. It's going to be great stuff. Tonight, I believe, was the last UFC event of the year, which is not bad since how they had four in the last 2 weeks. So, can't wait to see that January 2nd fight. I think it's gonna be really good. Overall tonight, those four fights I thought was pretty good stuff. But remember, check back on the 2nd, and you know, I try to have a review for that, and check my other stuff. I got a lot of other content. That's me. I had a high pitched voice. A lot of other content on my page. Just check us out, and you guys have an incredible day.